Hey guys, welcome back to Drive Driver Driven. I'm Humble, and we're back on the GBS Zero build. What you saw was me prepping the rear uprights. Those are the donor parts that shipped with the GBS from the UK. Of course, they had a bunch of rust scale. They lived a long life in the UK, so we're giving them a good hard retirement in California. So what I want to do is knock down that rust scale, give them some fresh paint, and see how they turned out. They do need some new hubs and new bearings pressed in, but if the mars the paint later, we can go ahead and redo that. So here's just a quick glance at the work that I did. All right, so there you can see some fresh paint. They still look pretty scaly. I'm not completely happy with it, but it'll do for the moment. I think either new uprights or having these blasted and really cleaned up is in the future. But for now, we can get them on the car for mock-up. Next up, I want to talk about order of operations. Basically where you have to do A to do B to do C, that sort of thing. So right now, what our end goal is I need to get the rear diff in the car, and I need to make sure that the rear suspension arms fit. But if you notice, down here, we have this kind of section here that sticks out, and I think that's going to interfere with the upper suspension arm. So this is going to need to be trimmed, but I need the front arms to do that. So if we go over to this pile, this is the upper arm, but you notice that it doesn't have any bushings in it. So we come back over here, and that's what this guy's for, is to help put the bushings in the arm so I can put the arm on the car to figure out how much we have to trim or where we have to trim. And then we can put that rear corner on, and thus the order of operations. All right, right towards the end of that clip, you saw me having a little bit of trouble with the vise. And despite everything, my vise broke. I can show you. I believe this is like a Harbor Freight vise. Super cheap, cheaply made, etc. And what happened was, right here, there was a washer that keeps this arm from going into the vise itself. You can see that kind of slides back and forth. Well, that washer disintegrated and it was pulling this handle inside of the vise so you couldn't turn it anymore. So I had to take this completely apart, run to the hardware store, pick up some larger washers, a little more robust washers, put everything back together, oiled it all up. So now it's really nice. And since it's working so smoothly, I was able to bang out the rest of the arms, but it's just like, if it's not one thing, it's another. So, done with this for the moment. And now I can show you why we were doing that. So let's go back over here to the car. All right, so here's our rear A-arm setup. This is our lower arm and our upper arm here, and you may notice, oh, it interferes with the body over, let's see, there, right here. And we need that arm to be able to come up to about this level. Now, it would also hit on this side. So I'm gonna have to trim this up, make it look nice, and then trim into this a little bit so that we can get full travel on our upper arm, and then duplicate that on the other side. I figured, well, if I have to have the cutting tools out, might as well do the rear differential. So this is the orientation, looking at it from the back of the car. This is our kind of diff center line, and my helper Kumo. This line and this line are where we're gonna chop these arms off because they will interfere inside of the back of the car. And then there's gonna be three holes drilled, which are, it'll be centered on this section, but it's gonna look off-centered in the car. Let me show you what I'm talking about. It's these three holes here. And if you look, this is the center and everything's offset a little bit. So when we chop the arms, it's gonna line up basically with this diagonal. So here and then here. So that adds 5 inches from center on this side and like 6 inches from center, or 6.5 inches on this side. And so when we chop those off, the top of the differential will bolt here, and then you can sort of see it down there. That lower pickup is gonna pick up under here on this guy. And there's a dowel that sticks out. You can kind of see it there. And that's gonna line up with one of the holes. And then that sets this solidly mounted inside the car. So right now, we're gonna pull out the power tools and do some trimming. All right, and There you go. So we've lopped off the sides. And as you can see, that's how much longer the right side is than the left there. And now we're ready to bolt that into the car. And surprisingly, I thought this was gonna trim a lot of weight, but it's an aluminum housing, so this doesn't actually weigh all that much. I would say maybe a pound or two for the two of these. Right into the recycling. All right. So up next, we're gonna try to get this in the car so we can figure out where to drill these holes up here. They should line up in the middle, one in this window and one in this window, about halfway through. That's the goal. Let's see if that happens. Whew. Okay, I'm gonna let you guys in on a little secret, but differentials are heavy regardless if the housing is aluminum or steel. It took some doing, but I got the differential in here. I'll show you. You just saw the clip of kind of drilling the holes down through the top of that kind of cross member. And that's what it looks like in the car. Never mind these, you know, temporary bolts. I just wanted to get it put in, but we have three holes here. So the housing itself is bolted to the chassis solidly, as it were. There's no like urethane or anything like that. It's solidly mounted to the chassis. So we have these three bolts on the top side that hold it in. And we'll go around to the bottom here. And on the underside, this is that kind of spacer locator I was talking about that comes down through here. And then these two bolts, which go directly into the housing, they're short like 10 mil bolts. One up front in the nose and then one here in the back. And those hold on what used to be the power plant frame mount on the differential. It just holds on right here. And that's it. It's just this point and the one up above. And then here through the side, you can see that's the area that we cut off there, how it lines up under the chassis. So overall, not too shabby. I would highly recommend getting a second pair of hands when you're pulling this guy up into the chassis. That was probably the hardest part of this job, doing it by myself, but I'll need to pick up some new hardware for this because I don't believe it came in the kit, so just some 1-inch bolts or so for those, and we're done with the differential. Now for the sides, we got to clean up this, and we're going to have to trim into this area. And that's what I'm up to next. Now, see how well this shows up. On these arms, they have a notch, and that notch should actually go towards the front of the car on this side. All right, looks like we're actually gonna have to trim quite a bit here in order to get this to fit the way we want it to. So I'm gonna grab a Sharpie and we'll mark out kind of a nice little section here and cut that out. The thing we need to watch for is right here along this line is our rear shelf. And then actually in this area, we have probably like 4 or 5 inches of clearance to the gas tank. So we don't need to worry about this section so much. We just got to worry about where this line is here. So we'll do our best to avoid that and then come and cut this section as we need. and we'll start with that and see what kind of clearance we get, and then we might have to come in this way a little bit more, or you know, we can clean this up, make it look a little nicer. But this whole area is going to be hidden behind the fender anyway, so I'm not too worried about it if it's not pleasing to the eye. I'm half tempted to actually put a like a rhino coat or a bed liner in this area so it's not too beat up. We'll see, but for now let's go ahead and trim what we've marked. All right, now we'll check the arm. We get full travel up to here anyway. I'm not sure how much farther it needs to go, but I think we may take it up a little bit farther, at least until up in here. Again, in this area is where our trunk is, and so from this point it was 2.5 inches, which is here. And then we're just going to go from that point straight down. Like so. And let's see how that turns out. That's our max travel. And like I said, I hope that's enough. I think that's gonna be more than enough. So I'm gonna grab a file and clean the cuts up, and I think we'll be done. All right, and then I'll repeat for the other side, and we're good to go to start bolting the suspension on.